makeshift, whatever you want to call it. And I decide I'm going to walk across. I ain't going to do it. Valerie squinched. She said, please, Pastor, don't do it. Please, Pastor. I don't know if she's doing that because she don't want to see me fall, or she knows if I fall, I'm falling her way. I don't know which is the case, but trust me, I ain't going to do it. But it is like me walking on this and walking all the way to the very end. And the truth of the matter is when you're walking, like those folk doing those tight ropes and all that type of carrying on, the key to them staying on the balance beam or the tight rope is balance, yes, but it's also they have found some way to remain stable. And so as we are walking across the tight ropes and the balance beams of life, what we have learned is that the Lord keeps us stable. He keeps our foot from being moved, us losing our balance, us slipping, and then therefore falling. That's what the Lord does. He keeps your foot in this context. He keeps your foot from being moved. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but maybe you're trying your own attempt, your own balancing act, and you're trusting in the wrong thing and in the wrong people. It's not the tightrope that you trust in. It's not the balance beam that you trust in. My brothers and my sisters, it is the God who keeps you up that you are trusting in. And if He is going to keep you up, you need to keep your head up and keep looking to the hills. Why? Because it is He and He alone who gives you the help that you need. Have I got a witness in here? He keeps your foot on balance and keeps you from slipping and falling. But not only does He give you stability. As a matter of fact, if I can just say another word about stability. When the Lord gives you stability, that is the Lord keeping you on track.
Amen.
He's keeping you on track. And I don't know about you, but I'm speaking to someone here maybe that has lost track. You've lost hope. You've lost your footing. You've lost a whole lot of things throughout the course of life because, you know, man can let you down. And trusting in the wrong things can let you down. But when you keep your eyes up looking toward the hills from what's come of your help, the Lord gives you stability. Why? Because you're walking on, trusting in, and or keeping your balance on the right thing. Amen. You must keep your footing on that solid ground. Christ is the solid rock in which we stand. All other ground is sinking sand. Trust in the Lord. I promise you, my brothers and my sisters, He will keep you stable. But not only will He keep you stable, He will keep you safe. He'll keep you safe.
Amen.
Because the truth of the matter is, watch this, the Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. And the psalmist acknowledges and recognizes that as he keeps his head up and he keeps his eyes looking to the hills from whence cometh his help, he knows that it is the Lord, my brothers and my sisters, that keeps him safe. He says, because my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Now, heaven and earth, we know that in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. He created mankind. He created everything that is within the context of existence. And if God is able to make all things and keep and sustain all things, don't you think He can keep and sustain you? Amen. Don't you think that He can keep you safe?
Come on.
We trust in the Lord because we know He's able to keep us stable, but we also know that He's able to keep us safe. If you don't believe me, ask young Daniel as he's in a lion's den. And in that lion's den, these raging and roaring and hungry lions. But yet, even in the midst of being in the lion's den with raging and roaring and hungry lions, yet they did not touch Daniel. He was not harmed and he was not injured. If you don't believe that, then walk with me, if you will, and take a journey and go and talk to the three Hebrew boys who were in a fiery furnace. And as those three Hebrew boys in the fiery furnace found themselves with a situation that was beyond their ability and their control, yet they found themselves walking out of the fiery furnace and not even smelling like smoke. Can't nobody do that but God. Can't nobody keep you in the midst of a difficult situation but God. And here it is, the God to whom they trusted. Because y'all remember the story, we've talked about it many times, but even as they were going into the fiery furnace, they said, our God is able. They said, but even if he does not do what we know he can do, we are careful not to bow down and worship you, King Nebuchadnezzar. My brothers and my sisters, even in the midst of a fiery furnace, keep your head up. No matter what you face in life, keep your head up. Came out, was not even touched, not even smelling like smoke, not even any of the hairs on their body had been singed. Oh, my brothers and my sisters, he will keep you safe. Have I got a witness in here on my head? He'll keep you safe. I know there's someone, at least one person in here that can attest and that can testify how the Lord has stepped in right on time and has kept you safe. When the enemy tried to do you in and the enemy tried to take you out, the enemy stepped in and kept you safe.
Amen.
Let me see if I can make this thing live. Story was told that was going on in heaven, and all the characteristics and of God was there. Love was there, kindness was there, generosity was there, and all that, and grace was there, but his sidekick, mercy, was not there. Mercy was missing. Y'all know everywhere you see grace, there's always mercy. They are the, what I call the dynamic duo,
amen,
the divine dynamic duo. You don't see grace without seeing mercy. They're two peas in a pod. They're always together. They're like peanut butter and jelly. They're always together. They stay together, but everyone is there, but mercy is absent. And they were wanting to have a meeting. They had this important meeting that they needed to have, but they needed everyone to be present. They could not start until everyone was present. And so they asked Grace, Grace, where is mercy? I don't know where mercy is. We were together earlier, but we got separated and sidetracked. I don't know where mercy is. And then all of a sudden, they looked down the road and they saw something, someone approaching them. And they said, who could it be? Who is that who's walking our way? It kind of walks like mercy, and it kind of looks like mercy, but when you take a closer examination, the robe that mercy has on is soaking wet. And the robe that mercy has on seems to be covered in soot and ash. And the robe that mercy has on seems to be shredded on every end. And the robe that mercy has on has blood stains. Surely that's not mercy. But as this figure got closer, they discovered, yes, indeed, it was mercy. And they begin to inquire, begin to ask, mercy, what's going on? Why are you late to the meeting? And why are you covered in soot and ash? And why are you soaking wet and blood stains? And your robe is torn to shreds. Where have you been? What is going on? And mercy said, I understand how important the meeting was. And I was on my way to the meeting. But as I was getting closer to the meeting, all of a sudden, I looked down from eternity and looked into time. And I noticed there was three Hebrew boys who were in a fiery furnace who were about to meet their demise. And they looked up and cried out, Lord, have mercy. And I immediately bust through eternity, entered into time, and went into the fiery furnace and kept them from being destroyed by the fire. That's why my robe is full of soot and ash. But I got back on the road after protecting them and keeping them, and I was destined and determined to get to this meeting. And as I got a little bit closer, I looked down from eternity and looked through time, and I saw a young boy by the name of Daniel who was in a lion's den, and there were raging, roaring, hungry lions who were about to devour him. And he looked up to heaven and said, Lord, have mercy. And I immediately bust through eternity and entered into time and went into that lion's den and kept those hungry lions from destroying poor little Daniel. And that's why my robe is torn to shreds, because instead of the lions harming them, the lions scratched me and scratched my robe, but he didn't do Daniel any harm. Got back on the road, and I promise you I was determined and destined to get to this meeting. And I got a little bit closer than I did, but all of a sudden I heard another cry. And as I listened and tuned in and focused on what was going on, I noticed it was the children of Israel, and Pharaoh was out on their trail. And on the one side was mountains, on the other side was the desert, and ahead of them was the Red Sea. And I saw them complaining and losing hope and losing confidence in God, and they even began to ridicule and talk badly about Moses. And Moses looked up to the heavens and said, "Lord, have mercy." And immediately I busted through eternity, entered into time. And I went and I parted the Red Seas and allowed the children of Israel to cross from one side to the other. And they were not harmed by the waters. They were not harmed by Pharaoh. They were safe and sound. But as I was holding the waters apart to keep them safe and allow them to cross to the other side, the enemy was hot on their trail. So I had to allow the waters to come back together again and destroy their enemies. And in the process, I got drenched. That's why my robe is soaking wet. But I promise you, I was destined to get to this meeting. I got back on the road and I was on my way. And as I got a little bit closer, I heard a cry like I had never heard before. I heard a scream and a holler, and the sun refused to shine, and the world began to rock to and fro, and darkness descended upon the land, and there was a cry. I promise you, was down and look at
children of God, I've got to go. I'll leave you right here. But the Lord that we serve will never leave you nor forsake you. And he will sustain you and keep you satisfied. That was a good word right there. And I promise you missed it. That was your cue to shout. But you was too busy to run. Look, you shout to the Lord because the Lord is your help. Shout unto the Lord because the Lord is your strength. Shout.
Keep your mind stayed on him when it's all said and done. Keep your head up.